So the month of Nisan starts tonight. It is the month of celebration, the month of redemption, the month of gathering together for the Passover Seder, which will be a little bit different this year, as we know. Not as many people sitting around the Seder table this year as in previous years, maybe a few more than were sitting around the table last year. I just want to reflect for a few moments on the importance of ritual. Rituals aren't just fun things that we do to amuse ourselves. The purpose of ritual is to teach values. And Jewish rituals, like all rituals, teach important values for our community. What do we want people to internalize about how to live as a human being in the world? We start teaching rituals and the values behind them at the earliest age. Our ancestors were told, you're sitting around the table, you are preparing to leave Egypt, and you are going to create rituals that will cause your children to ask questions. Ma ha'avodah hazot, what is all this about? And you are supposed to tell them a story, lidorot, across the generations. And the story is that we used to be slaves and now we were free. And by extension, what that means is that slavery is not acceptable for a human being, that I deserve freedom, and by extension, you deserve freedom as well. We start at the earliest possible age. So a rabbi was once actually talking to a group of three-year-olds and trying to explain the Passover story in a way that the three-year-olds could understand. So the rabbi said to the three-year-olds in a loud and dramatic voice, we used to be slaves, and now we are free. And one of the boys raised his hand and said, actually, rabbi, I'm free and a half. So we have to make sure we start early, and we have to make sure that the message gets across. Folks, this morning, we are putting forth and publicizing a special fund that has been created in memory of Ronnie Katz. Ronnie Katz, who died a little bit over a year ago, is known to many of us as Mora Ronnie. And Ronnie would lead a service every week in the Blue Room recently. For the last 30 years, she led the service. And it was aimed toward the youngest children, toddlers, preschoolers, but also toward their families. Ronnie led this service every time that she could. And recently, when she was weakened by illness, she would still lead the service as often as she could. And I will tell you, having seen her lead the service so often, that as much joy as the service gave to the children and to their parents, it gave at least as much joy to Ronnie herself. So the Mora Ronnie Tat Shabbat Fund is going to provide a beautiful stuffed Torah to the young children within our congregation, to the children of current and New Temple Israel members under the age of 5, newborn children of members, along with a note about the legacy of Mora Ronnie. Now, as I said earlier, rituals teach values. So I just want to point to one ritual that Ronnie would always do with the children each and every week, and the value that that ritual taught. So at the beginning of the service, each child was greeted by name and welcomed by name, and she would sing, "We welcome you today, Hayom." And when I would walk in, it would be Rabbi Stecker, Shalom, Shalom, we welcome you today, Hayom. And I would say hello, and the kids would say hello to me. And that happened to each and every one of the children. So what is the value behind this? The value behind this is that every human being is welcome as they are. You learn that when you're 2 years old. You learn that you are welcome by your own name. You are actually welcome as you are to this beautiful, holy space. And I will tell you that if I had to distill the most important value that I, as spiritual leader of this congregation am trying to get across, it is that each and every human being is welcome in this space. Welcome as we are, welcome to be called out by name and to be received by name. And if we do nothing else, and if we teach nothing else besides this value, which Mora Rani reinforced every week through a very simple and very catchy ritual, then we will have performed a great service. And that pun was very much intended. Today, Victoria celebrates a milestone, and she spoke so beautifully and warmly about the importance of sharing gifts. Victoria enters the Jewish people as an adult, because we don't just believe that Judaism is for children, we teach children so they will carry the values with them into adulthood, and they will continue to explore and exemplify those values as they mature. So I want to say to Victoria, we welcome you today, Hayom. We welcome you today as you are. We welcome you, the wonderful person that you are, and know that you will continue to grow in every important way as the years continue to unfold. And in keeping with Mora Rani's legacy, we pledge to continue to teach our most important rituals, starting at the earliest stage. Everyone is welcome. Everyone gets to grasp and hold on to the Torah. Everyone is welcome Hayom today and each and every day moving forward. And we pray that these rituals and the values behind them will last for many, many lifetimes. Amen.